I hope you guys are doing well. So we are at part 6 of this Blender Beginner series. So in this part, we're going to be creating the ocean, the sky, the sun, and the volcano over here. So this series is actually starting to get a little too big for my taste. So I'm going to try to cram in more things in one part, and probably on the next part, we're just going to be animating it and creating the materials. So yeah, let's get started. So first of all, we're going to be needing a new collection. Right click, new collection. Call it environment. I don't know, my keyboard isn't working and my spelling isn't that great right now. So shift A, mesh, plane. Call it C and give it a placeholder material, also called C. Like I said, we're going to be creating the materials properly later on. So S100. Oh wow, we actually need to scale it a lot bigger. About at least it should cover the sides. Okay, so tab into edit mode, right click and click subdivide, and now on the subdivide menu, click over here and then tab adds 50. So now we have 50 subdivision. Now tab to come out of edit mode, add in a modifier. We're going to be adding in the displace modifier. Okay, and the strength is going to be 0.1. And click on new and then click on this part to create a new texture. So we are going to be going for the edit clouds, look good, and then right click to shade smooth it. So this looks pretty neat actually. On the older version, it was actually pretty hard to get it right. So yeah, now the next thing we're going to be doing is creating the sun. So shift A, I think everyone knows where this is going. Create a UV sphere, scale it by 50 or so. You can add a subdivision surface modifier on it as well, but I'm not going to do that. So GX to move it on the side about over here, and also give this some material, new material called sun. Change it to emission since that's what it's going to be, and give it like this orange shade of color. And strength of 5 for now. Like I said, we're going to be creating the materials later on properly. So now we're going to be creating the sky. So shift a mesh, add in a cylinder. Keep the subdivision same because this is going to be covering a lot of area, so I guess that works. S by 50 again for now. Tab into edit mode, select the upper face, select the lower face, shift X, the lower face, and then X faces, GD faces. Tab out of edit mode and then right click to shades mode it, and then scale it like this to, you know, cover a lot of area, and then S shift Z. I don't know why it's doing this, it did the last time when I was trying to do so as well. I don't know why it's acting like this. So just scale it around over here for now, and then S Z to scale it a little lower. For some reason, my tree is still glitching on a few parts. So for now, this is good enough. And then set this energy Z to move it a little bit bigger. We are going to be adjusting the position of the sky. It on the Blender can create skies on its own, but since we're going for a stylized view, that's why. You know, we are creating this sort of slender effect. So now for the volcano. So for the volcano, usually you shouldn't do this from the start, but you need to know what Blender is capable of. So first of all, just hide the station, road, lights and light instances, and go to edit, preferences. Although for now, this is what I'm teaching you, that Blender can do a lot of things with add-ons, but you shouldn't just jump into add-ons right away. You should first do things your own way, and then after a few months, like 2 to 3 months, then you can you'll automatically know what add-ons you need. So type in landscape, okay, landscape. On the add-ons panel, in the search bar, type in land, and you will get this ant landscape add-on. It's built in add-on, so right click to enable, tick this to enable it, then we're good to go. Now click on shift A, mesh, and on the click on landscape. Now this is really small, but it's actually really high poly. Don't click on anything around or else this menu will disappear. So click on this menu. You can actually get so many different add-ons like abstract, canyon, below, default, crystalline, large terrain, etc. A lot of them are really useful for testing or something else, but we're going to be using the volcano one. Click on volcano, and when you change the random seed, you get different type of volcano. So I'm going to change random seed to 8. You see it actually change. So stamina was, I think, good enough. So yeah, now I'm going to scale. Also, this is really high poly. If you tab it, it's pretty high poly for our scene. So tab out of it, and then let's just scale it by 50 for now. and then gx to move it a little bit of backward about over here. And now we also need to add the trees. I don't know if anyone noticed or not, but there were sort of trees over here, so we also need to add the trees. The link in the, of the tree image is in the description below, because we're going for low volume approach. That's why the link is in will be in the description for this image. So go to image and images plane this time, okay? And mine is in desktop, so I'm just going to go there and it's called C tree. Oh, I think I actually messed up. Delete it. Shift A, image, images plane, and click emit. Okay, this way it won't be shaded or faded out. Desktop, and now we're going to select this C tree. So by default it's laying down like, so RX 90 to move it over here, RZ 90 to move it like this, and yeah. So scale it up a little bit. Going to material preview to see it, what it looks like. Tab into edit mode, select all of it, and remember, just move this guy and this. See, this origin, this is where it needs to, you know, the base of the tree needs to be around this origin. So G is there to move it above over here, because when we're going to be using it as particles, it's going to be problematic. So that's why. So right now, come out of edit mode, and then G is there to move it downwards. Select the volcano, give it a new material. I'm just going to call it volcano, and it's going to be this simple brownish type of material. So first we need to wet paint it, because we actually only want the trees to be appearing on the front side of volcano. Like I said, wet painting is used when you want a specific effect to only happen on a specific area. So click on the volcano, go into wet paint mode. So there are settings of our hood, but you can also right click to access the settings. So for now, I actually want the radius to be 30, and I'll just paint this front part of the volcano. The red area is where the effect is the most, and the blue area is where there isn't any effect at all. Okay, so now that we have wet painted it, go to object mode, add a modifier on the volcano, take a modifier, add a decimate modifier, because this is too high poly for us, okay, so for our scene. So I'm just going to reduce it by 0.1 or maybe even 0.05, so you can see that it's a little bit of detail is reduced. So now I'm going to apply it. So now if you go into edit mode, you can see that subdivision have been reduced drastically. So now click on this panel, this particle properties, click on this by selecting the volcano. Plus, to add in a particle system, material is used for when you actually want it to emit something out. I don't know if it's going to be, if you can see them, there are tiny particles over here that are moving downwards, but we don't want this, we want the hair settings. So you can see small hairs are coming out, but if you want, actually want the hairs from just the front part. So instead, because we actually want them to be only in the front part, we're going to be using the vertex group we created before, the weight painting we did before. Okay, it's called group. The particle system in the length tab. Click on this and click on group. So now the hair is only appearing on the front parts, and we don't want too many trees. We actually only want a few. So click change the number to 50, or maybe a little bit more, like 60 or so. And on the render, change the path into object. The instance object, select the C tree image, and change the scale random value to 0.3, and change the scale to so you can see a little bit of trees over there. Okay, now we can see them. So I think that's good enough for now, or maybe 0.35. So scale random actually changes the randomized values. They are not all the same size as the values over here. So now that we're done with that, on the next part, we will create the materials and probably animate the sea, so that we can just finish the series. So I hope you guys learned something today. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. See you next time. Goodbye.